If you think the Vortex helps you get things in focus, try becoming a premium member on RealCatholicTV.com for the best shows on earth. The benefits are out of this world.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Vortex, where lies and falsehoods are trapped and exposed. I'm Michael Voris. Every time I see a new set of numbers or polls or survey results showing things are not well with the church, I recall a conversation I had with a bishop a few years ago in his office when he said, kind of dismissively, we were talking about polls, "Well, don't believe every poll you see." I was a little more than stunned by that piece of advice. I also realized instantly that he and many others in the church either do not know or probably do not want to know the magnitude of the crisis before us. It was a head-in-the-sand response, if I ever heard one. I was tempted to ask him, "Well, do you see any polls, even one, that suggests something different?" But I didn't. It was very evident that such a conversation would have led absolutely nowhere. See, when you look at polls and surveys a lot, what's important isn't so much any one individual poll, but the trend of a large group of polls taken together. A group of polls with similar findings, very similar findings, from totally different organizations more than suggests a trend. They almost guarantee it. The individual margins may vary slightly here and there, and that's to be expected, but polling science today is so sophisticated that if you spot a discernible trend and there are no other polls or surveys indicating an opposite trend, then you can pretty much take it to the bank. That's why the latest survey, this one from the Association of Religious Data Archives, is relevant. This outfit measures hard data such as church attendance, as well as opinions of religious adherents. They've been around for quite a long time, and they have a huge archive of information. So their findings shouldn't be really dismissed easily. What do they have to say? Well, loads, actually. They just completed and published a survey of over 200 religious groups from, get this, every county in America. That's a lot of work and very specific. They do this once every 10 years. Probably takes them 10 years to do it. Here's a brief section from their summary of looking at how religious adherents have grown or shrunk in these past 10 years. After saying evangelicals and unchurched were exploding in their numbers, the report said, quote, "Still not everyone was a winner. Mainline Protestant churches lost an average of 12.8% of adherents in the first decade of the 21st century. 5% fewer active members were found in Catholic churches," end quote. What do most Catholic parishes in the U.S. have in common with mainline Protestants? They do not preach the hard truths. Forget about what can be found in the magisterium. If those teachings are not preached from the pulpits, taught in the classrooms, presented in conferences, used for guidance and confession, employed for direction and private discussion, stressed by the bishops, explained in seminaries, then they aren't getting to the people who need to hear them. And as is evident in poll after poll after poll and finding after survey after report after every blasted study that gets published, if you don't preach the truth, people leave, even if they find it hard. Of course, some people will leave because they find this a, quote, hard saying. Our blessed Lord saw that firsthand when he revealed himself to be the bread of life and gave the command to eat my flesh. But in the end, for the hundreds, perhaps thousands, that initially walked away, billions came to believe. But we also need to analyze and discern through these numbers exactly what Catholics are leaving the church. You can rest assured it isn't traditional Catholics. Their numbers are growing, and believe me, the modernists and progressives in the chanceries are having hissy fits over this. They continue to try and block and dissuade young men who actually believe everything the church teaches from either entering seminary or getting ordained at the end of seminary. They are using priest personnel boards in numerous dioceses to prevent traditionally minded priests from becoming pastors. In some cases, they're actually using this excuse of not enough priests to close parishes before they would promote a traditionally minded priest to become a pastor. They resist with every bureaucratic roadblock they can throw up, in direct defiance of the Holy Father's stated wishes, mind you, the establishment of traditional Latin Mass parishes. And when they do cave in, because someone writes a letter to Rome ratting them out, they allow the Latin Mass in the farthest corner of the diocese at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, or approve of said mass in the middle of the ghetto, hoping that these roadblocks will discourage people from attending. But their little games, however devious while appearing to be innocent, are not working. All over the world, it is traditional Catholics who are on the ascent. Modernist Catholic parishes are closing down, being merged, clustered, sold off. The weak-kneed, non-fruit-bearing branches are being cut away by the vine dresser so that more abundant ones may flourish. The numbers are still small, so small that they won't register in a nationwide poll, but two more polls from now by the ARDA group, in 20 years, things will look very different in the church. Remember, every flood always starts with just a couple of drops of rain. God love you. I'm Michael Voris.